Knowing your people is critical so that you know whether or not they need that extra call or they need to FaceTime with you because they need to see someone physically. If you know their personality style, then you know who might be at higher risk for having suicidal ideation during this change in the experience of our society. Until 4 years ago when I joined Air University, I was actually a consultant to the Department of Defense on the topic of suicide. When we change our social contact with each other, we tend to feel a bit of fear. Some people might be scared, some people might be more anxious. So if you weren't an anxious person before, you might start experiencing anxiety in ways that you never have before. So it's important to recognize that this is not a very fluid progression in terms of how we're going to get through this. Give yourself some grace that you're going to be experiencing things that you might not otherwise experience in a normal routine. I think because our normal routines have been interrupted, that might also be particularly difficult for people who have or do experience depression and anxiety before this experience. They may feel more disconnected. And of course, feeling disconnection is a core component to suicidal thinking. It's feeling a sense of burdensomeness, feeling a sense of disconnectedness, and then feeling a lack of fear or fearlessness about actually following through on dying by suicide. So it's particularly important for supervisors to reach out to people and try to lessen that distance and build that connection at this time. So I think it's really challenging our norms and our way of thinking and about engaging with those that we supervise to know that and encourage them to continue working hard, but adjusting to a different routine. And I don't think, I worry because in the military environment, we're very structured. And so we want things to be in a certain way. And as a society, we don't like working in gray. And this is very much finding the gray, being in the gray, finding yourself thrust into the gray, and needing to find a new way of working from home. There will be an end to this. At some point, we will loosen up the isolation guidelines, and we will be coming back together. Not just about the Air Force offering mental health support in different ways, in creative ways now, but making sure that we adjust and recognize that there may be more work to do when people return.